Hello, my name is Bruce. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to add a range function to the accounting period to report across multiple periods in a financial reporting report. This is the third of six tutorials for designing reports with the Financial Reporting Web Studio. The range function can be used to create a rolling 12-period report. I'll start by opening the Select Members Accounting Period dimension and then select the range function. First, I'll need to remove the default selection, and then I'll click the Functions tab, where I can select the range function. We want to configure the range to present balances for the last 12 months from the period chosen at runtime. A new window opens where I must select my starting and ending members for my range. I'll begin with the start member. I'll select the relative member function for the start period parameter, because it lets me define the periods that display in my report relative to the period I specify at runtime. I'll select the member option for my relative member. I'll select the current point of view for accounting period option so I can enter the starting period for my report. The offset determines the first period of our range. The start period in the range function is always the oldest period. Because this is a rolling 12-period report, I'll enter negative 11 to include 11 periods prior to the period I enter at runtime. The 12th period will be determined by the member selection in the end member parameter. Now I'll enter the end member of my range. I'll select the current point of view here too. To complete the definition, I'll close out the function windows to save my report. I'll use the HTML preview to see how adding a range function affects my financial reporting report. My report still doesn't display any balances because I have not made a member selection for all of the dimensions. In the next tutorial, I'll show you how to set the user and grid point of view. Thank you.